some people still thought that they were a good buy, and even a business proposition.
I had a tiny little business called Economy Motors, and while I was going to the auctions, I found that Morris Minors used to crop up. And the great thing, if you're in the banger end of the market, is that the car should start. And I found that these funny little Morris Minors always used to start. And also, they used to get you home from the auction, you know, while one would be pushing the odd Ford or Vauxhall up the hill, you know, the Morris would always get you home. I then thought, well, maybe there is an area one could specialise in. Of course, at that time, I mean, you could go to auctions and buy Morris Minors by the dozen, and the army used to sell off them by the hundreds, so that getting the stock was no great problem. I think the other thing was that the sort of brand loyalty was quite extraordinary, that as soon as I started selling Morris Minors, one got a different class of person, as they say, or punter, coming into the yard. And they were all serious people who actually wanted simple A to B transport. And that if you had something that worked, and you also explained why it wasn't perfect, that they were the sort of people who would actually accept that cars are not necessarily perfect. That you didn't have to do a big sales hype in order to shift the metal, as they say in the motor trade.
Into reverse. Rev the engine. Clutch back until it just begins to fade. Handbrake off. Turn the wheel right round to the left. Right round, down with the clutch. Straighten the wheel up. Stop now. Now, handbrake. Into first. Rev it a little. Clutch back till it just begins to fade. Get the wheel right round. Quickly, down with the clutch. Dear, dear, dear. Right round with the wheel. I've run this Morris Minor since 1976, teaching people to drive. It has done 370,000 miles, 340,000 of them with learner drivers. I run it because it's simple to maintain, simple to drive, and I don't spend all my weekends servicing it. Change the oil every 10,000 miles, and a bit of welding underneath every MOT usually. I look at it, why tie 10,000 up in a car when you can tie 500 up in the car to do the same job? So many of these modern cars, you have to have specialised equipment because they design them that way to stop you fiddling about with them. Or people like me fiddling about with them. In the days when these first monocoques were made and when car design engineering was developing, they tended to build in extra strength, a bit for luck, as it were. It certainly made the car slightly heavier than a modern car, but at the same time meant that it was maintainable, it was durable, and was not likely to collapse. Certainly no normal modern Eurobox has that kind of structural life, because they're not perceived in that way. But with this, you can go on cutting it out just in the way that one can cut brickwork or stone out of a house and replace new stone, you can replace joists, you can cut the dry rot out and put back the new material. You can do that right the way through the car, because the whole thing was put together by people, and therefore what has been put together by people can be taken apart by people. Them all over Asia. I mean, there are 20,000 alone in Sri Lanka, and something like 35,000 in Malaysia,
the taxis in Islamabad are Morris miners, and they're Morris miners in India. I mean, they're everywhere where the old empire stretched.
In 1980, Charles Ware went to Sri Lanka to see their Morris miners in action. 3 years later, he met his partner, Dhana Samarasekera, and the durable car company was born.
The factory opened on the 20th of April, 1991. What we're doing is building up from a very small workshop situation of, say, 50 or 60 people, to 1,000 people over the next 4 years. And during that time, we will be making components for the Morris miner, initially. Then we will be building sub-assemblies. We will then be building possibly body shells or sufficient panels for those body shells to be assembled in the UK and all over Southeast Asia. From my having roamed around the world looking at Morris miners in all kinds of countries, I think the thing is it's a damn good car. You know, that's the way they look on it in Asia, you know, that it bloody well works. It again is took things from all over the world, in a sense, to design the car, but he put them together in an individual way. So I don't think it's a sort of, I don't think it's really a kind of English noddy car.